minutes each. The two remaining parties have 2 minutes each. Mr. Cooper, you have the floor for 4 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Former Liberal Minister Baines, you led the committee to believe that you had no active role in the appointment of Ms. Verschuren beyond receiving a recommendation from the Prime Minister's Department, the PCO, as part of a so-called open, transparent, and merit-based process. You know that that isn't true, just as you knew it wasn't true when you misled committee in June. Isn't that right, former Liberal Minister Baines?
Thank you very much for the question. As I've highlighted before, Ms. Verschuren was appointed by Stephen Harper, Jim Flaherty,
Former Liberal Minister Baines, let's follow the chronology of events leading to Ms. Verschuren's appointment, someone who was in a conflict of interest at the time that you appointed her. On March 15th, 2019...
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Ms. Khalid.
Is the former employer of the official opposition's wife out of order in calling Mr.
Ms. Khalid, come on.
You,
in fact, are up next, so you will have a four-minute right to the floor at which you'll be able to take full use of it. Mr. Cooper, you have just over 3 minutes, please.
Former Liberal Minister Baines, let's follow the chronology of events leading to Ms. Verschuren's appointment. In September and October 2018, the PCO received 54 applications for chair of SDTC. On March 15, 2019, they provided you with a short list of 5 recommended candidates. That's the process you keep referencing. You sat on your hands. You ignored the recommendation of PCO. In April 2019, according to Ms. Verschuren, you called her. You asked her to serve as the chair of SDTC. All of a sudden, on April 30th of 2019, 1.5 months after you had a short list of 5 recommended candidates, she applies. And on May 21st, 2019, the PCO adds her name to the short list and you thereafter appoint her. Do you really expect this committee and Canadians to believe that she was picked as part of a transparent, independent, merit-based process and that you didn't have your hand involved in picking her? Is that what you want Canadians to believe?
It was an open, transparent, merit-based process. And as I've highlighted,
you
former
knew.
Prime Minister,
no, what happened here,
Stephen Harper,
what happened, former Liberal Minister Baines, is that you didn't follow the process. You didn't respect the process. You politically interfered in the process.
As I was trying to state before, Ms. Verschuren was appointed by Stephen Harper to the Canadian North American Competitiveness Council in 2006. Jim
Did the
Flaherty
other five
appointed
recommended
her to the economic...
candidates have conflicts of interest with SDTC because Ms. Verschuren had a conflict of interest? What happened about the other 5 candidates?
Again, when we're speaking about Ms. Verschuren, I was highlighting the fact that she was appointed by Christian Parity, the former minister to science, technology,
Mr. Baines, you're not answering my question. I asked you, did the other 5 candidates also have conflicts of interest? Because Ms. Verschuren had a conflict of interest at the time you appointed her. $12 million that her company was receiving from SDTC, and you knew about that.
Just one, Mr. Cooper, I have a point of
order. All public office.
Sorry, Mr.
And I truly respect Mr. Cooper, but he's asking the witness to opine on some other members that were part of a board. I just don't know what Mr. Baines can say. We know that the former employer of the leader's wife
is
asking tough questions.
This is not a point.
Well, it is a tough
of order.
Well, it would be dismissed. It'd be thrown out of court if it was a real court.
Well,
but this is a kangaroo court.
As government members are prone to remind this committee, we are not a court. This is a question and answer session. So,
thank you so much.
I've said that before many, many times because it is not a court. We're here to ask questions and receive answers. So, Mr. Cooper, you may proceed.
Mr. Baines, did the other 5 candidates have conflicts of interest as Ms. Verschuren did, yes or no?
It's important to note that all public office holders must respect and follow the Conflict of Interest Act.
You were advised that Ms. Verscheren had a conflict of interest, and you appointed her anyway. I'm asking you about the other five candidates. You refuse to answer, and I take it that they didn't have conflicts of interest, and you appointed someone with a conflict because you don't give a damn about conflicts of interest. Isn't that right, former Liberal Minister Baines?
During my tenure, I made over 100 governor and council recommendations, and it's important that all those individuals that were recommended and ultimately appointed follow the conflict of interest.
You knew she had a conflict of interest. You didn't give a damn,
Mr.
and as
Cooper,
a result, $400 million taxpayer dollars have gone out the door.
Mr. Cooper, I will just remind you that
conflict-ridden appointment.
Mr. Cooper, I remind you, as I was reminded today in the House, that we will use parliamentary language in this committee room, Ms. Kalina.